Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com and welcome back to the channel and welcome back to this awesome tutorial series on Duck UI, SwiftUI on UIKit. Well, it's kind of strange, but you can do that, kind of. And today we are going to talk about shadows and corner radiuses. So stay tuned and let's jump right into the code. Okay, now shadows and corner radiuses are notoriously hard to handle. Well, basically, you could easily add one or another, but both, they are quite hard. So with DuckUI, I have created a new, let me just see here, SC image view and SC button view. Now, basically what this does is adds shadow and corners for our buttons or image views. Today I'm just going to talk about the image view, but the same applies for our button view. Okay, make sure that you have already installed or updated DuckUI. If you are just starting out, go ahead and take a look at the previous videos in this episode. There are quite a few, but if you're just wanting to just install DuckUI, take a look at the first one in the playlist. You can see all of the links down below. So today we are going to create a simple image view and let's add real easily shadows and corners to them. So first of all, let's create our image view. So lazy var, maybe image view equals, and so let it be of type D_SC for shadow, corner radius, yeah, you know, SC image view. Okay, let image view equals D_SC image view. And let's just take a look at what we have here. Well, we have our image view, we have a radius, color, offset, opacity, and corner radius. Now the corner radius is for basically the image view's corner radius. The first radius is for the radius of our shadow. So let's create our image view here. So let's rename this to inner image view. So yeah, it's inside this SC image view, and that is a UI image view, and let's have it with a UI image, and let me hit Command Shift M to pop up the media library. If you will be working on Xcode 11, that is Command Shift L, that will bring up the library, and you can select either your code snippets, your images, but make sure you select your images. So I will just drag and drop my image here. Double click on it to make sure it does not crash, so you can basically see the image. And inner image, Alex, inner image view. Let's drag it in there. Radius, let's have 5. Color, let's use one of our new colors, or rather yet, let's have this. Yeah, let's use our D color. Now, D color is kind of Xcode 11's color and Xcode 10 colors available in DuckUI. Go ahead and take a look at the previous video that I have recorded and just previously. And or it discusses everything about that. So let's use this, maybe a dark, and let's use the blue one. Yeah, dark blue. You will see that how that looks like. Okay, offset, maybe let's have CG size. Let's see here, 5 and 5. I don't know, maybe we'll see how that looks. Maybe I will bump it up so we can really see how that is. Opacity, maybe 0.7. Again, the opacity is for the shadow. Corner radius, let's use, let's say 15 for now. Okay, so what else do we want to add this image view? So let's have our content mode, maybe. Let's have this scale aspect fit. So scale aspect fill. Okay, that should be right. Let's just wait. Oh, I need to return. So we get basically back our completion from Xcode. There we go. That should solve this issue. We have our scale aspect fill ready. And while we are here, I know it's kind of a bad idea, but I will show you anyway that it can be done. You can set the size of the image view right here. So image view, set frame. Again, set frame is a .UI property. CG size. And let's have this with a width of, is it 200 by 200. Okay, that should be okay. And now that we do have our frame set, we just need to add it under setup views with safe area. Make sure you take a look at the, at least at the few beginning videos of this playlist to understand how this DView controller works and why it is so easy to just throw those views over there. So stack, we are going to use layoutless. Vertical, yeah, layoutless, another cool feature of DuckUI. Basically, it's a separate GitHub repository, so no applause for me, thank you, but it's really cool. So fill in parent and layout in container, and that's that. And let's see here, let's add, yeah, simply just add in that image view. It should work really fine. Okay, and yeah, maybe because we have that width height, maybe it will scale it, or rather stretch it. Let's just see, and if it does, then I will just add it into separate, or maybe add some views there. Yeah, it does stretch it quite a lot, but you can already see that here we have kind of that bluish shadow, and we do have that corner radius. But just so we can see a little bit better, let's add this into a horizontal let's just add, yeah, let's just add, I don't know if it this is the best way to do this just yet. Most probably it could be better off, but I would just add this into a horizontal stack. There we go. Let's just go, and I will add a spacer here. There we go. Let's add that missing comma, and adding a spacer here too. So yeah, that should put it, I believe, on the top left corner of our screen. So let's build and run again. Let's see how that looks. Hopefully I'm correct. Yep, that's it. Let's add some divider here. Again, divider, take a look at the other episodes in this series. And I will use a horizontal divider of type, let's say medium, or let's use normal. That will be okay. So normal divider. And while we are at it, let me just have that corner radius to half of our width, so 100. Okay, you could just use this outside and set it as a constant and then just cut it in half. But yeah, now you have that real circle-y, let's say profile-ish thing here. Yeah, it looks really, really nice. Okay, and I believe we still have this stretch because this content mode is set for the image view, but we want to set the content mode to the inner image view. So let's do that. And now we should see Bender look really, really nice. By the way, Bender is from Future Marma, if you have been living under a rock for the last 20 years. Okay, there we go. Real cool shadow and corner radius for our image views. The same goes for buttons and of course for views too. Now, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel and hit that notification bell to be notified of new videos, because in the next videos we are going to talk about further styling our views with DuckUI. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.